Hey, what is up, everyone? Welcome back to another Warhammer 40,000 unboxing, and I guess it's a review as well. And I am so super excited about these. These are the Japanese exclusive Space Marine Heroes Series 2. And as you can see from the box here, these are Blood Angels Terminators, and I'm pretty sure you can paint them as whatever chapter you like. But I guess we'll see once we bust them out. And once again, as usual, this video right here would not be possible without those awesome people over at HobbyLink Japan. And unlike the last box of Space Marine Heroes, these ones won't cost you an arm and a leg. So if you want some of your own, check out that link down there right now in the description. Now let's get to this. So once again, this box right here is essentially what the shops get in so they can display them. So it opens up kind of like a display. Whoa, orb going by the camera there. Haunting. Honestly, this box is a little bit subdued compared to the last one, which was a Rhino Transport, and again, a huge box. Personally, I prefer if they keep it cheap and small, that way you can get the whole set just like it says there, including the captain this time around. But anyway, that is enough about the box. Let's get this one busted open. Looks like we push this bit in. These parts are perforated. Oh, there we go. There is also a paint set as well. I don't think HobbyLink have it, sadly. There is another orb. So haunted. But anyway, yeah, that one comes with pretty much all the paints you need to paint some Blood Angels, as well as another exclusive Blood Angels Terminator. But then again, that one wasn't available to me, sadly. So we're just gonna have to go with these guys here. So how does this fold open? Yeah, it seems like the whole lid comes off just like that. And okay, so I'm just gonna have to quickly distract from the review right here, because every now and then you'll see this little orb thing moving around. There it is. It's coming down now from the top. And I can't do anything about that, because that actually is a tiny little Tyranid inside the lens of my camera. Inside the lens, not on the lens. I can't do anything about it. This camera I'm using for this right here doesn't autofocus, so it won't really work. So we're just gonna have to ignore it somehow. But anyway, back to this. Okay, so anyway, let's take these one at a time and see what we've got inside of them. There's the front of the box, this side with SpaceMarineHeroes.com on it, and there is our guys this time. There's a slightly different sort of data card in here. I'm not exactly sure what this is for. But anyway, there is the 6 Terminators we can get. Let's bust this first one open right now and see who we've got. So these runners are quite a bit larger than the ones we saw last time. And straight away in with the captain. We can see the iron halo right there. So we know this is the captain. As for what else is in the box, we've got that little fold out leaflet. I'm sure this shows all the guys that you can get. Brother Durago there, that's the guy you get inside of that paint set. Try to ignore that bug. And who we got in this one here is Brother Captain Donato. And what's around on this side? Basically just how to put it together. Again, these are snap fit, so you don't need glue, but of course it's recommended. So there is the card. So this time around we do have some English on it. We do know that the Space Marine Heroes Season 1, at least most of them, not all of them, are coming to the West. So maybe this is their way of kind of pre-preparing for that. Anyway, the quote here says, "On this world, the fate of a star system will be decided. Brothers, we cannot fail." The symbols down here make some sense this time because it's elites. Terminators are elites, of course. And HQ, it is a captain, so this could be used as a HQ. Once again, around the back as well as the portrait, this is written in English, so I'll pop that in right there so you can pause it and read it at your own leisure. Either way, this is looking cool. Of course, it seems like it comes with a helmeted head and a non-helmeted head like before. And there is the sprue. Look at that scenic base. That looks really damn good. Craters, debris, plate metal, ammo clip. There's a whole lot going on there. Anyway, let's not waste any more time. Throw them together and see what he looks like. So finally, there is the captain snapped together, and he is looking absolutely and utterly fantastic. If you think about it, the price point of a captain from Games Workshop is usually around the 25 euro mark. This box right here, the whole entire 6 of them, costs around 31 euro. So essentially, what you're getting is a HQ as well as the squad of 5 as well, which is pretty awesome. The pose looks savage. It does come with the combi melted there. It kind of reminds me of the Cataphracti captain. But the pose is much better. This looks epic. There is a side-by-side comparison of what it looks like with the helmet off as well as the helmet on, and both look amazing. On to box the second. And this is Brother Sergeant Victorno. Once again, we have a quote there on the front. You can pause that if you want to read it. There's what the finished model will look like as a Blood Angel. Flip it around. There is the portrait as well as that little blurb. Again, if you want to read that, pause it right now. Same little leaflets we saw before, and finally there is the sprue. And this guy is rocking a Thunder Hammer and Storm Shield combo, and there is the base. Again, this is one of my favorite things about these little figures. Those bases look incredible. Let's put them together. So next up, there is a spin of the Terminator with the Thunder Hammer and the Storm Shield. And this pose right here looks fantastic. Stepping up onto that boxy type thing there. Thunder Hammer raised into the air with that shouting face. This looks so good. This is what I love about these kind of pre-posed, easy to build figures. Especially these exclusive ones here. The poses look so natural, so perfect. Once again, there is a side-by-side picture of it with the helmet off as well as the helmet on. The helmet here is pretty standard looking, but the shouting head looks perfect. On to the next one. And in here we get Brother Senectus. There is the painted image of what he will look like as a blood angel. Lightning claws. There is that quote. Flip it around there to the portrait as well as that blurb. Once again, you can read that in your own time. And let's check out that sprue. So once again, there is the minifigure looking fantastic. Just like with the other ones, this is, of course, stuck in one pose. And once again, there is the base. So next up then is the Terminator with the lightning claws. Another awesome pose here, like he's charging forward. I will mention here, I haven't mentioned already, but none of these guys have any Blood Angels iconography on them whatsoever. Just standard Terminator iconography. So that means these can be used as any Space Marines chapter without modification. That's pretty cool. I'll mention at this point that the heads aren't necessarily swappable, because as you can see, this guy right here, he's got a hole, and the head for using with it has a peg sticking out of it like so. However, some other ones have a peg inside the collar section, and the heads have the hole, so they're not necessarily directly swappable, the heads that is. Once again, there's a side-by-side of the helmeted head and the unhelmeted head. The unhelmeted head this time around is your standard angry bald Space Marine. Halfway through already, and on to the next one. And there is the card, and this time it's Brother Mayclus. So there he is with his heavy flamer and chain fist. There is the quote. There is the sprue, looking very nice again. Both sides of the heavy flamer there. There is the base, again looking unique. Looking awesome. Now let's put them together. So there is the Terminator with the heavy flamer and chain fist all put together. Once again, awesome pose, awesome base, looking great. This time around, as for the two heads in here, we've got first up is that standard Space Marine unhelmeted rebreather head, and the other one is your standard looking Terminator helmet, looking slightly off, which really matches the pose very, very nicely. And just a quick side-by-side with the old heavy flamer Marine I've had from so long ago, 15, 16 plus years must be, and I have to say, things have come a long, long way. This thing looks fantastic. On to the second last one. This time around, we've got Brother Faello. There is the finished picture of what it will look like painted as a Blood Angel. Standard Terminator loadout right there with the Storm Bolter and Power Fist. We've got some more images here, which I'm not sure what they're for. There's the quote. Flip it around. We've got the portrait of Brother Faello as well as that little blurb there, which of course, once again, you can pause and read. There's the sprue. Once again, this is a fairly standard looking Terminator right here. We do get two alternate heads. That is the one with the helmet, the one without the helmet. I love that they include both. And that right there is the base this time around. Looks like he's standing on something compressed. Probably not the best idea. But anyway, let's put this thing together. Over halfway through them now, and this one right here is your Terminator with its standard loadout. Nice pose here, leaning slightly onto that compressed fuel tank. The standard Storm Bolter and Power Fist combo. All in all, this right here is a fairly standard looking but nicely posed Terminator. There are both heads once again side by side, both of which looking off in the direction of the Storm Bolter. All in all, this pose is great, and another fantastic little mini right here. And the last one. And of course, this has to be the guy with the Cyclone Missile Launcher. And there he is, a Terminator with a beard. That is pretty badass. This is Brother Ebelius. There is that finished image of what he will look like. There is that quote. Around the back there, we have the portrait as well as that blurb one more time. As for the sprue, there it is. We have both the helmeted version of the head there as well as the one with the beard. That is a savage head right there, looking awesome. And of course, lastly, there is the base with that broken Imperial Street. And lastly, let's put them together. And finally, there's the last one with the missile launcher on the shoulder. And I have to say, this is gargantuan. It looks fantastic. I think I've said that about all of them, that they look fantastic, but they really do. This is an impressive little model right here. It is all made even better by that bearded marine head in there. That looks great. There is the two heads side by side. Why you wouldn't use the bearded one, I have no idea. But again, both look great. So just as a general size comparison at this point, there is the size of it compared to a standard marine. There it is beside a Primaris Marine. And once again, there is what it is like beside a super old school Terminator. And this is the really bad Mortifactors color scheme I was running with, many, many years ago with that Goblin Green base. And there it is side by side with one of the last set of the Space Marine Heroes. So it's pretty big, but pretty standard for the size of a Terminator. So that is it for the review, and I have to say I'm so hype about these. I love exclusives. I spend pretty much every day on eBay looking for old, current, new exclusives all the time. So something like this I just had to have. If you're like me and you have to have them, you can grab yours at Hobby Link Japan. I did put a link down there in the description. As always, make sure to come back for more Warhammer 40K reviews and unboxings, and I'll see you next time.